Colorado, checking in at No. 3. And all right, get excited. This kid is going to be fun to watch. Cale Makar. And this is a guy who won the Hobey Baker for UMass Amherst, came just a couple of goals shy of winning the national championship. He flies to Colorado, doesn't play in any regular season games. He jumps right into the postseason and has an immediate impact for the Colorado Avalanche. He was a first-round pick back in 2017. And you talk about a tandem on the blue line, maybe coming up in a couple of years, Cale Makar and Bowen Byram. Wow. Byram was that guy you thought Chicago might take, third overall, dropped to the Colorado Avalanche. All right, let's talk about it. How excited are you about the Colorado Avalanche and their future, especially a kid like Bowen Byram? You said maybe the steal of that draft.
Well, you sit there. He wasn't the steal of where he was picked, but I think for them, he was a steal that he fell into their lap at four. And I think they're sitting there.
The rich get richer.
Yeah, I mean, you're sitting there, and I don't know, maybe this team wasn't necessarily looking for a defenseman coming into this draft, but when they get this guy, oh my gosh, yes, we will take him gladly at No. 4. And you've got him, adding him. Let's look at the NHL level. The NHL level, you have good youth on that team there, you know, led by Nathan MacKinnon. Probably one of the top lines in hockey, or is one of the top lines in hockey. They made a lot of different moves. They were so deep now with their D, with Bowen Byram and Cale Makar and Samuel Girard and the other company that they have there, that they got to the point where they're like, all right, well, we can do kind of without Tyson Barry now. We could trade Tyson Barry. We got other guys who can slot in.
It's like
in.
The blueprint of Nashville at this point,
it's
right?
Great. Yeah, once you get, D are so hard to come by in this league. When you keep stacking the cupboards, like they did in Nashville, and it worked for them for 15, 18 years, where you have that D, you move the D off, you have another D coming in. And when you have guys like that that you can move out, you can make big moves. Now they end up getting a Nazem Kadri, a motivated player. They fill out their forward roster quite a bit, but the big pieces for me are on that back end. Samuel Girard just got re-signed long-term. You got Bowen Byram, Cale Makar. I mean, that's some serious stuff to start with in your lineup, and I think that's really nice too, because you're slotting Eric Johnson and Zadorov appropriately where they're at. So this team is going to be very nice this year and for many years to come.
Yeah, that was projected D pairing coming up in 2021, 2022. Connor Timmins on that second pair, second round pick, the same draft year as Cale Makar.